I told my boss that I wanted to become a millionaire, and this is what he had to say about it. So to give a little backstory, I was working at this company. It was a company for healthcare, and I don't want to say too much about it. This company was a fairly big company in New York City, in Manhattan. And I was working there for a period of time as an intern. And so I had this boss that he was a cool guy and he let me lead my own projects. He was great. And so everything, you know, for the whole experience I was there was awesome. I loved it every minute while all the other interns hated it. But it was nearing the end of my term there. And so my boss decided to take me out for drinks. I was hoping that my boss would eventually ask me if I would like to join the company because I did so well at the company and I got so much done for them. Well, it turns out that things happened with the company and their budget couldn't meet the requirement for hiring any more people. So unfortunately, I was not able to get that job. It didn't really bother me too much because I said, okay, I can just go and find something similar and I'll be fine. And you know, he told me that if I wanted to work there and be guaranteed a job, in his words, you basically are guaranteed a job if you wait 4 months until we can hire you and we have the budget next year in January. And I said, well, I don't know about that because I want to keep moving forward. I was growing and growing and I just didn't want to wait 4 months and hit a wall for 4 months and not do anything when I could get a better opportunity. He said, Gabe, what is it that you want to do? I said, well, I'd like to be, you know, working at this company. He said, what is it that you want to do? And I said, well, what I really want to do is I want to be a millionaire. And the look on my boss's face when I said that, it went from this to this. And it was just like, you know, it had taken him back. And in this situation, my boss looked at me like I was crazy. And he said, well, the job will be here in January. But if you choose to move forward, I understand that you want to keep growing. I said, I'm glad that you understand. These are my plans. I would like to keep growing as an administrator because I want to eventually start my own business. And I want to have my own financial freedom, I told him. I said, yeah. So he gives me a hug, says goodbye. And so 4 months pass. And at that point, I actually had gotten no job. I had gone back and I emailed my former boss and I sent him an email and I got no response, nothing. He said, and mind you, he said that I would be guaranteed a job. Now, it doesn't matter what he said at this point, but the way that the reaction that he gave me when I told him that I wanted to be a millionaire, really, it said it all already. He had seen that, you know, I was going way over my head and my expectations were too high. He may be a little bit more of a cynical, realist person. That's just how he was. You could just tell that the whole dynamic of our relationship completely shifted when I started talking about my goals of how I wanted to be massively successful and how I wanted to be a millionaire. Everything changed. And when those things happened, I never heard from him again. He completely cut me off. I emailed him a couple times. I texted him a few times on Thanksgiving. You know, I said, Happy Thanksgiving. That was it. I didn't get one response back. So it just goes to show how where people are in their mindset and what they think of people who have these big aspirations, these big dreams. It was a little bit discouraging when I didn't hear back from him. And it wasn't discouraging when I told him I wanted to be a millionaire. I know what I want to do. And it's just a goal that I want. And it's not that I want to be a millionaire now. I'm ready to put in the work and put in the time, put in the effort. And so I guess maybe it's just not for everyone. Not everybody has those same goals. They don't set a standard because, you know, I guess maybe they're just happy, either happy where they are, or they just believe that in order to be a millionaire, you have to be born into it, or you have to get lucky, or you have to be working super hard, working your face off until you basically die with your fortune. No, you can be whatever you want. And especially if you believe in yourself and you do the inner work first, because first you have to take care of the foundation. The foundation is going to take care of you later down the road when you hit those really nasty storms. When those waves are crashing against your foundation, you're not going to crumble. When the wind starts to pick up inside of a tornado, that foundation is going to hold. It's going to stay stable. And that is going to be your inner work. That is your foundation. This turned into a motivational video, I know. But if you have people in your life right now that are telling you that you're wrong for wanting to do what you love, you're wrong for wanting to do something that you find true joy and enjoyment and that you want to achieve, people are going to tell you these things out of their own insecurities, and they're going to gang up on you and tell you that it's not possible, it's not going to happen. It won't happen if you listen to them and if you give up, because anything really is possible, and you just have to have put in enough time, enough work, and enough effort. I know that all of my failures happen only because I gave up, I felt discouraged, and I stopped doing it. And so you fail if you give up. So that's pretty much my story and his reaction and what happened. And I hope that if you are in a similar situation, that you stand your ground. Make sure that nobody makes you doubt yourself. I certainly didn't doubt myself. I know that guy maybe have doubted himself a little bit in the past, but that's not gonna be me. And that's not gonna be you either. So take this advice, and I hope it helped. And if you like this video, be sure to subscribe, tap that like button, and stick around for more content on self-love, mastery of the mind, the body, and the heart, and videos about personal and spiritual wellness. My name is Gabriel. This is the Ascension Link. Take care, live well, and live truly.